Let's take a look at VPN. A VPN is a virtual private network. Two things that a VPN does is it encrypts your data and also gives you anonymity when you're on the web. So whenever you have an internet service provider or ISP, some examples of ISPs are AT&T, Comcast, / Xfinity, Charter, which has Spectrum, and there are a lot of other ISPs. I'm just listing three of them right now. So to get on the internet and watch Netflix or Disney, you have to have an ISP. You do not have to have a VPN to be on the internet, but I highly encourage you to have this VPN, whether you're at home or definitely when you're out in public at a Wi-Fi, a coffee shop, if you're traveling and a hotel has Wi-Fi, paid or free, you should be on a VPN. I use a VPN even when I'm at home doing personal stuff. If you work for a company and you work from home, most likely your laptop is going to have a corporate or company VPN already installed on it. That VPN, when it is running, allows you to access your intranet, possibly your LMS, and a lot of other internal items that if it's not running, you're not going to have access to. We're going to run through showing you how the VPN works, but basically it's really simple. Without the VPN, when I connect my internet service provider, which happens to be AT&T, they can see my data, they can see what websites I'm going to, and they can track stuff. If somebody was trying to do something, a hacker was nearby, that hacker could possibly steal my banking account information and passwords. So I want that VPN encryption to help me out with this. So let's go and see how my IP address looks with my VPN turned off. And then I'm going to actually demonstrate why a VPN is so cool. So here we go. I've been playing around. All you have to do is open up a web browser and type in what is my IP. Right now, my VPN is turned off. So it says my IP address. Notice that IP address right there. But what's interesting, I'll go ahead and tell you this, AT&T is my internet service provider, and I do live in Marietta, Georgia. So I'm going to go turn on my VPN right now. Just because you sign up for an internet service provider does not mean you get a VPN. Usually you have to go and pay for these. I have no recommendations, but there are a ton of them out there. Just go Google them. I'm going to go ahead and pull up one right now that I have. So I'm running, I use Bitdefender in this part of my package, Bitdefender VPN. Notice right now it says turn on secure connection. I'm going to click it. I've got it set to automatically connect. And as mentioned, I'm over in Marietta, Georgia, so it connected. Notice that now I have a private IP address right here. So let's go and refresh this page and see what happens. I can promise you it's going to give you the same IP you just saw, 185.930.139. Notice it no longer knows who my internet service provider is. So my data, I'm using a VPN client on my computer. My data is getting packaged and sent over to my VPN, and it is a secure connection now to my ISP. You do lose a little bit of speed when using a VPN, but the loss in speed, the benefits of the VPN are well worth the loss of speed that you're going to have. And it should be minor loss of speed. So here I go again. So it did pull up Atlanta, but still not Marietta. Watch this. I've got my VPN running again. Let's say now another advantage of a VPN is, let's say I happen to be traveling overseas. So my computer would pick up, let's say that I'm over in Europe in France. My computer would pick up that I'm in France and I may want to watch Netflix, but it's only available to the United States. I would swap this over to the US so I could watch my Netflix in the US even though I'm in France. But I'm going to go the other way. As an example, here I am. I'm going to go and pull up, let's go Canada. It's saying, hey, we got three VPN servers in Canada. I'm going to just pick Montreal to pick one. Connect. It is connecting. I'm going to get a new IP address. Your connection is secured. So now again, if I come over here and refresh, I'm going to get the exact same address that it's telling me over there. By the way, look down here. It's telling me that I'm in somewhere in Canada right now. So there you go, why you should have a VPN. So never ever, I cannot stress this, never ever be in a coffee shop and connect, use their Wi-Fi without a VPN. Same thing for a hotel. So now here's a few frequently asked questions in case you're wondering. If I have an ISP, do I have to have a VPN? I've already answered this. The answer is no. You definitely need an ISP to get on the web and watch your movies, but I'm telling you, you should have a VPN. When do you use the VPN? Again, already answered, coffee shop and hotels. Does a VPN keep you from getting malware? Malware could be viruses, ransomware, spyware, phishing attempts. The answer is no. The VPN is not going to keep you, though, from getting malware. So you need some other form of security on your computer. And finally, will I lose speed? Yes, you're going to lose a little bit of your connection speed because it's doing the encryption, but it should not be a significant loss in speed. I appreciate your time.